What's up everyone, welcome to my channel. This video is about tire inside and its secrets. In this video you will learn tire's composition, understanding the tire material and its curve, how tire affects the power consumption of the vehicle. Okay, so without spending much time, let's start now. So tire looks simple and they look much the same to an untrained eye. So if you give the different tires to one untrained person, he will say that all the tires are same, but they are not. The tires differ in the various things and lots of engineering is involved in it. For example, the tire can be differ in the percentage of the rubber, or it can be differ in the make, that is whether it is radial or bias tire. Tires are hiding a very advanced engineering secrets inside their black rubber casing, and the variation in the tire builds are endless. Even the black rubber casing itself is full of high-tech and carefully guarded secrets. The tires are not only the tires, lots of engineering is involved in it. So now let's see the tire composition. So I am having two type of tire here, the passenger or the light truck tires and the truck tires, the heavy truck tires. Let the first tire be tire 1 and the second tire be tire 2. So if I compare the percentage of antioxidant, antiozonins and curing system in tire 1, it is 14% and in tire 2 it is 10%. So what they actually do? The antioxidants prevent from oxygen, as the name says, and antiozonants, they prevent from ozone. The third, the curing system, they helps in vulcanization. What actually vulcanization means? Vulcanization means the hardening of rubber. The next is the natural rubber. Natural rubber 34% in tire 2 and 19% in tire 1. They help in tear and fatigue crack resistance. Fine. The next is the synthetic polymers. That is 11% in tire 2 and it is 24% in tire 1. So what actually synthetic polymers does? They affect the overall performance of the vehicle. Okay, and they are impermeable. What actually impermeable means? Impermeables means that they help in maintaining the inflation pressure. Next is the steel, 21% in tire 2 and 12% in tire 1. Steel, basically steel is used for making of belts and beads, and this stiffens the tire and improve the road handling of the car. Okay. Another is a textile, 4% in tire 1 and 0% in tire 2. Textile, name suggests, they are the fabric cords and they're reinforced in the tire and they maintain the dimensional stability of the car. The dimensions are maintained because of the fabric cords. Last is the fillers. So 26% in tire 1 and 24% in tire 2. The fillers are the carbon and black silica, and they improve the wear performance and traction. They also helps in rolling resistance. Fine. So any material can be shown by three notations. These notations are, the first is the spring, as you can see the symbol spring. The second is the dashpot. To those who don't know what actually dashpot are the dampers. They damps the forces. The basic difference between the spring and dashpot is the springs stores the energy and then splits them out, and dashpot stores the energy but then it disappears it. Okay, so that's the dashpot. Now another is the friction. You can see the symbol of friction. So the springs. So elastic materials are shown by the springs. Their notations are spring because they are elastic in nature. The metals are shown by the springs and friction. Springs and the friction. This can be parallel or series combination. The springs plus dashpot for elastomers or the viscoelastic materials. Okay, so the viscoelastic materials can be shown by this parallel combination of spring and dashpot or the series combination of spring and dashpot. The parallel combination is called the Kelvin model and the series combination is called the Maxwell model. Fine. So the tires are the elastomers or the viscoelastic material. So here we are going to see the two curves of first the elastic material and the second the viscoelastic materials. Let's see the curve. I'm going to see this curve only in the elastic region, that is from point A to point B, only in the elastic region. So when you increase the load from point A to point B, the curve reaches at point B. And if you remove the load at point B, the deformation again becomes zero by following the same path. I'm again saying I'm comparing only in the elastic region. Okay, so loading and unloading line is same in the elastic material. So what happened in the viscoelastic material? As you can see, the curve, the solid line is for the loading and the dashed line is for the unloading. So the loading and unloading line is not same in the viscoelastic material. This is because of the interaction of the long chain polymers in them. Hence, this causes the hysteresis loss in the elastomers or the viscoelastic material. So as you can see, this region is the hysteresis loss. Fine. So here, as you can see, the tire is rotating, and this rotation leads to the compression and expansion of the tire treads. As the tires are the elastomers or the viscoelastic material, this cycle of compression and expansion of the tire treads causes the hysteresis or the energy loss in them. Okay, so the loading and the unloading of the tire treads while rotating leads to the hysteresis loss, and this loss is compensated by your engine of the vehicle, which affects the fuel efficiency of your car. Okay, so because of these reasons, choosing a perfect tire and maintaining it is very important. If you don't choose a perfect tire or compatible tire for a vehicle, then there will be more hysteresis loss. And if your tire is not maintained, they are veered out, then go and replace them. Not only it will help you in the road grip, but also increase the fuel efficiency of the car. The tire should be properly inflated for your car to minimize the hysteresis loss. Okay, so thanks for watching. This much for this video. And if you like the video, if you like my content, hit the like button. And do share this video with your friends, with your colleagues. And if you have any queries, hit the comment box. And also the last, don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you want any updates regarding vehicle dynamics, you can check my blogs on my website. Okay, so till then, keep learning, keep exploring.